Here we're asked to solve an absolute value inequality. The first thing I'm going to do is isolate the absolute value by subtracting 15. So negative 3 times x minus 5 has to be less than negative 30. Now let's be careful here. When I divide by negative 3, remember when you divide or multiply by a negative number, you have to reverse the inequality. So it used to read less than, now I have greater than 10. Okay, so on the left side, those negative 3's cancel, and then on the right side, negative 30 divided by negative 3 is 10. So now I have a absolute value inequality, which is case 3 of the theorem in the principal notes. Basically, for that to happen, the argument x minus 5 has to be less than negative 10, or x minus 5 has to be greater than 10. Okay, once you have it broken up into two linear inequalities, just solve each one like normal. So x here is less than negative 5. All the numbers less than negative 5 should solve the original inequality, or here I'm going to add 5 to both sides. Or any number greater than 15 should solve the original inequality. So let's graph these, let's shade these on a number line. Okay, so all the numbers less than negative 5, I'm going to use an open dot. That's non-inclusive, shading everything to the left. And then all the numbers greater than 15 should also solve the inequality, so I'm going to shade everything greater than 15. Now let's convert that to interval notation from minus infinity to negative 5. Parentheses there, that's a non-inclusive negative 5 union. Parentheses 15 to infinity. So this is the interval notation that represents the shading here on the graph. Those are all the real numbers that solve the original inequality. You should actually test a few, you know. Try 20, see if it works. Try negative 10, see if it works. Doesn't hurt to check your answers.